My name is Rambo from Chobe River Safaris. Welcome you to Chobe River Sunset Cruise. I'll be doing the boat cruise on the Chobe River, which is the border between Botswana and Namibia. Other side of the river is Namibia, and behind us is where Chobe able to join Zambezi River, where four countries meet: Namibia, Botswana, Zambia and Zimbabwe. And in front where we are facing is where the national park it is, Chobe National Park. And this river, when it reaches here, divides itself into two channels. Then it forms an island which is in front called Sidudu Island. In front of us there we saw some elephants, and there is a buffalo, which both of them are one of the big five. So these animals you see on the island, they swim across from Botswana side into the island. They know where water is not deep. They use those shallow channels to cross into the island, following the green grass. More especially this time of the season when it's dry, they like this green grass which is in the island. And they will be staying on the island until November and December, when the rain starts raining, is when they will be swimming out again, going up on the south. So they will be starting to concentrate from the rain water in the water holes. So rain season, they migrate up on the south. Then dry season, they come down to the riverfront here. So they've rain rotational grazing. We were also able to see other type of antelope, which they are called the red leechweed. Look similar to impalas, but they are good swimmers. They're always in the island. So those white birds you see next to the buffaloes, they are called the cattle egret. So they are going with the buffaloes to take the flies. When a buffalo is eating the grass, there is more flies which is flying around, and this white bird is keep on taking those flies. In front there we see a big herd of elephant, which is a bachelor herd, males group. Because in elephant, males only are allowed to stay with the mother when they are still young ones. So once they get matured at the age of 10 to 12 years, they are kicked off from the female group to avoid them to mate with their young sisters, to do what we call inbreeding. Then the oldest female, the matriarch, she will be able to kick them out from the female group. Then they will be able to go and make their own group. The bird you see on the tree there is called the cormorant. So this bird, they spend their time diving on the water to catch fish. So when they get wet, very heavy to fly, they are forced to come on the trees to dry themselves. You will find them spreading the wings, trying to dry themselves so that they can be able to fly. Okay, on the roots of the tree there, you see big lizard on the roots. It's called the Nile monitor lizard. So we have two types of the monitor lizard. This one is the one which is staying in the water, grow bigger up to 2 meters. So they spend their time on the water, eating the birds' eggs, crocodile eggs, also the fish. They mostly eat fish. So big enemy for them is the crocodile. Crocodile, they eat them because this lizard able to eat the crocodile's eggs. Also the big eagles, like martial eagles, they able to feed on this monitor lizard. This is the hippopotamus, which is one of the dangerous animals. Kill more people here in Africa. But you found that although they kill more people, they don't eat meat. They only kill to defend themselves. So this is the sign of telling us to get away from them. We are too close to them. front of us there we see the crocodile, which is medium size, still growing. And the type we have here of the crocodiles, they are called the Nile crocodile. They grow bigger, up to 5 to 6 meters full grown. And because crocodiles, they are cold blooded reptiles, they come on the bank during the day is to warm themselves, to bask the sun, to cook themselves warm. And crocodiles normally in winter, they don't eat a lot of food, only eat in summer when it's hot. Because what happened, when they eat food, 60% of the food they eat will be converted into fat. And those fat will be stored in the tail. So those fats are the one which helps them to stay longer time without eating. Big crocodile, they can stay up to 6 months to 1 year without eating. They are being helped by the fat which stay on the tail. You see the crocodile in the front, there is opening the mouth, is how they regulate their body temperature. And crocodiles, they don't chew, they don't have the tongue, only smaller flap inside the mouth. So when they are feeding, they cut big chunk by turning around, spinning. Then they turn up 90 degrees, then they swallow, because they have strong digesting system, able to digest all the bones, everything they eat. So they were able to digest. Front there, you see those antelopes, they are called the waterbuck, which the nickname, we call them the toilet sitters because they have white round ring at the back, at the tail. So normally these waterbucks, they are found along the riverfront. They are water dependents, always feed along the riverfront. And if you look careful to them, you will see they have shaggy hair, more hair on the body. It's the one which helps them to float while they are swimming across, going to the island, following the green grass there. Those two young male elephants you see in front touched each together. They are wrestling, just practicing to fighting for dominance, because they normally fight for female. So depending on the stronger one, the stronger is the one able to get into the female and do the mating before he go back to the male. And also this place where you see this big head of elephant here, they normally swim across on the other side of the island, following the green grass there. More in the family, there you will see lots of babies, because elephants, they have a baby any time of the year after 22 months pregnant. So one female elephant in the lifespan able to have up to 10 babies. So every 4 years to 5 years, she will able to have a baby, because elephant live longer, same like human being, 60 to 80 years. So in her lifespan, start able to have 10 babies. And female, they'll start to have young ones at the age of 5 to 7 years. So after waiting for a long time, this elephant now, their leader have decided to leave the herd. Now they are swimming across into the island, the Sidudu Island, for the green grass. Is where they are going to spend their night there, being able to come back again. Normally they wait for the leader to open, then everyone can follow. We hope we have a wonderful boat cruise with us, people to come and see this wonderful national park, Chobe National Park, which have a glory, especially on the elephant's population. We have up to 40 to 60,000 elephants, which believed is the highest number of the elephants in the world.